All right, this next one is inspired by a trip to Costco where we found some butternut squash pre-diced. We knew we wanted to do some short ribs, so we're gonna go into the zone, a low, slow approach with the slow cooker. These are the ingredients you'll need. 3¾ pounds of short ribs, which we're estimating at 32 protein blocks. 7 cups butternut squash, 21 carb blocks. 2 small onions, which yielded 3 cups or 3 carb blocks. 3 cups tomatoes, 3 carb blocks. 10 cloves smashed garlic, which we're calling 1 carb block. 1 6-ounce can tomato paste or 5 carb blocks. 4 cinnamon sticks, approximately 4 bay leaves. 1/4 cup extra virgin olive oil. I'm gonna start just by dumping this stuff in there. Butternut squash, onion, tomatoes, garlic, olive oil, cinnamon sticks, tomato paste in there also. Okay. 2 to 3 tablespoons of kosher salt to make this meat do its thing. Some freshly ground black pepper on there. Let's go in with a little bit of our mixture. Anytime you're doing something kind of long, low, and slow, bay leaves are a good way to go. I'm gonna sneak these in on the side. Just make sure to pull these out or look for them. Throw the lid on, get it in here. I'm gonna set it on low. I'm gonna go 10 hours. This will be waiting for me in the morning and we'll check back then. We're back. It's the next day. We've cooked our short ribs here for 10 hours. They've been resting. So I'm gonna pull the crock out here and just take a look. The first thing I do is just look for my bay leaves. Pull those out. And then you also have the cinnamon should be swollen like so. So I'll pull the cinnamon out. And then I'll use a spoon just to get in there and kind of see what's going on. This is also a good opportunity if you want to skim away some of the fat. But if you chill this, you can just pull the fat off the top. So then I'll take and just divvy this up into these pint containers, focusing on the meat at first. And I'll just take the rest and I'll ladle it on. 8 4-block meals. Yeah, so it's kind of like a stew, essentially, if you look at it now. Meat's super tender, just the right amount of salt. Cinnamon, not overpowering, but there. So next step is I'll cool all these down in the fridge. I'll keep 2 in the fridge, put lids on all of them, label them with what they are and the date, and then I'll put 6 in the freezer. These will stay for up to 6 months, depending on your freezer. I mean, they'll stay for up to a year, but I say after 6 months, things aren't really that appealing anymore. So there you have it, cinnamon-infused short ribs with butternut squash to help you stay in the zone.